What's going on, guys? Cody with Babe Gaming, bringing you guys my second episode of my Maryland defense coordinator here on NCAA Football 14 on SGU. And guys, we are going to look at my difficulty. As you guys can see, I am playing on Heisman with 6 minute quarter length, and I did change the minimum threshold all the way down to zero to create the biggest gap between faster players and slower players. So I know a couple of you guys wanted to see that proof, so I figured I'd bring the proof. I have nothing to hide, guys. I have no reason to lie to you guys, tell you guys that I'm playing on Heisman and play on freshman or anything like that, guys. So right there's your proof. We're going to keep this rolling so you guys see it go right into the game mode after you guys just saw the difficulty. And yeah, so there's your proof, guys. So we are going to rep the Pride jerseys. As you see, we're about to select them right now. We are taking on Virginia. They're 1-4. We are 4-1, guys. I'm not bringing you guys every single game, obviously, because one, this is not my channel. Again, big shout out to SGU for doing what he does. He's a good buddy of mine, and I appreciate it every time he shows my videos here on his channel. And two, just because I want to truck through plenty of seasons and get through a lot of seasons and advance my coach. So if you guys did not see the first episode, go ahead and check out the first episode. And if you did, guys, you guys know that obviously I explained that the reason for this is I want to upgrade my coach. I don't want to sit here and rebuild the team. It's also a main reason why I'm not recruiting until I actually settle down with a team that I feel like I can be with for a very long time. So until we find that team, we're not going to do recruiting. We're just going to play our defense coordinator, play on defense, do our thing, and hopefully we get some pretty cool offers. So guys, we're only looking to get about 3 videos or 3 episodes per season. So this is our second episode. Guys, we are 4-1. Like I said, the one loss that we had was to number 9, Florida State. So pretty crazy game. We almost pulled it off. I wish we would have. That would have been insane. But guys, it is on Heisman. I mean, it's obviously upsets happen, but unfortunately we could not come up with the win against Florida State. So we are still 4-1, guys, having a great season. I'm also excited. I love Maryland's jerseys, but I am excited to see what you know, what kind of offers we get here at the end of the season for other schools, and see where we can possibly take our coaching talents, whether it's to offense, back to defense, or you know, maybe even to head coach. So let's get to the game though, guys, and I'll talk to you guys in a bit.
You don't have to be a student at either of these schools to know that they have no respect for each other. This conference rivalry is a heated one.
It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
All right, guys, so you guys heard it. This is a huge conference rivalry. These two teams hate each other. And being a defensive coordinator, we want nothing more to lay hard hits on this offense, kill them, and make them suffer for coming here to Maryland and trying to beat us. So let's get it popping, though. As you see, we are taking Collins, and we're trying to make something happen. But look at Henry, the running back, taking off. And guys, we're already giving up a 31-yard rush. We need to change that. We need to make something happen. As you see, we pick up Collins again, and we get a tackle almost in the backfield on Henry that time. Now he's back out here, and now Franklin's going to get a tackle. So he got a 31-yard rush and then got 2 0-yard rushes. So out here on third down, he's throwing it over, and their wideout drops the pass. We force them to punt it. So great stand right away. We gave up a huge run, but ended up coming back with a nice stand. So now back out here. Look at that hit, though. You guys are getting another look. Look at that hit on Henry. Forces him to the ground. It's downpouring. It's going to be slippery. There's going to be a lot of hard hits. And it's going to be a very fun game. So now lining up, they get a huge first down. And our star linebacker can't come up with the tackle. But finally, we get Henry to get shoved out of bounds. He only gets a 2-yard rush. Now Johnson dropping back, trying to take off. But Franklin comes up with a huge 6-yard sack. And they do get a loss of 6. So now lobbing it up. Look at how wide open he is. And look at that broken tackle. He's going to take it all the way into the end zone. William Johnson. Johnson to Johnson for the completion for the touchdown, guys. You guys are getting another look right here. I took the safety. I messed up. I dove. I don't know what I was doing. And then the cornerback couldn't come up with the tackle. He ends up shoving him. and their wideout is going into the touchdown for the first score of the game. So now Virginia has the ball back again. Our offense does not do anything. We force William Johnson out of bounds after he just got a touchdown, already receiving more yards, and now we make a great third down stop, making it fourth and eight. So now 5 minutes and 35 seconds left in the game, guys, and they're running it up the middle with Henry. He gets a 7 yard rush. They're handing it back off to him. He's going to get another nice run. He breaks the tackle, gets the first down, and look at their mascot showing out. He's getting jiggy with it. But guys, Henry's out here on another rush, picking up another first down, and this is when I realized that Henry is not only one of their stars, but one of their huge targets. And now I bring the blitz, and look what happens when I bring the blitz. 32-yard reception by Thompson, their tight end. And now we are getting hurt, guys. Johnson takes off. There's 4 minutes left in the first half. We need to make a stop right here. We're already down by a touchdown. Johnson dropping back, taking off up the middle. He's definitely got the first down. He doesn't slide to get smacked. And now they're setting up here on first down. Rodgers, the backup running back. Look at all those broken tackles, and trucks his way into the end zone to make it 14-0. But our offense does score, guys. So now it is 14-7 here in the second half. We got a minute 15. We make a nice tackle, but we do end up getting a roughing the passer flag, and that's going to only advance them up the field even more. So Leon Franklin, the left end, picks up the roughing the passer. So now they lob it up over to the left side to the running back. Henry, look at that truck. Then we miss him with the second guy, and he still doesn't go down, but fortunately we get him out of bounds. Johnson lobbing it up over to Thompson, and we get another roughing the pass flag, guys. Leon Franklin, gets another roughing the passer flag, and now that's going to set him up very nice. As you see, they are handing the ball off to Henry. Looks like he could go. Fortunately, we bring him down at the 1 yard line, setting up first and goal. It's not looking good, guys. 14-7. They're calling the hurry up offense. We're going to call a dime package. We're going to bring a couple guys, but we're going to drop back in man coverage. We're going to bring McKenzie up the middle, putting on the pressure. Oh, he's lobbing up. That's picked off by Smith. Great defensive stand with 30 seconds left in the half. You guys are getting another look. Look at him keep his feet in. That is just beautiful, guys. Look at that footwork. And we do make the stop here on Virginia. Fortunately, otherwise they were going to go up at least two scores here on us before the half. So now they're out here in the second half. That ball's tipped, making it fourth and nine. We're already making huge stops. And in the second half, we are deciding to run more of the dime package, dime cover three, and a little bit of a dime cover two, and all sorts of different dime plays for defense. We ran a lot of 4-3 in the first half, and it worked a little bit, but for some reason, I feel like we're making more stops even on the run game in dime package, so hey, we're going to make it work. But look at that sack, guys. You guys are getting multiple looks here, and that was by our defensive tackle, Hurd, and he is definitely one of the bigger guys on the line and definitely one of the biggest impact guys on our defensive line. He's definitely having a great season already, and we're going to make things happen with him, so especially in this game. Johnson taking off, and Hurd comes up with another sack, guys, and you guys can see 3-plus sacks for this defense. We're getting achievements, and we're making things happen here as a defense coordinator. Luckily, he gets tripped up, and he does get sacked for more yards. Now we're out here on fourth down. Look at that tip ball. We had a chance to pick it off. Tied 14-14. We need a stop to give our offense time to score the ball. Johnson slipping up, whipping it over to Henry, and Henry does get dragged down fourth and inches. So they are going to punt it, because if they weren't to get it, they would be in serious trouble. So our offense does score, guys, 21-14. And now look at, he gets dragged down, and he does get sacked for another 2 yards. So now second and 12. Dropping back, Franklin misses. Hurd picks him up, and he breaks the school record for sacks in a game with 3, guys. I told you, Hurd's going to be a beast. So he's already making things happen for the school. He's going to have a huge season, I can already tell. But look at this bomb to Tatum. Look at that bomb. I ran with him a little bit. I didn't want to dive and give up a touchdown, guys, so I ran with him. Now 14 seconds left in the game. They need a touchdown. Johnson dropping back. He's taking off with the ball. I don't know what he was thinking. You need to pass the ball. But he did take off. They use their final timeout. Dropping back. 3-2-1. He's throwing it. Can he get a touchdown? Guys, that gets batted. That could have been picked off by our star linebacker, Parker. But he does get the deflection, guys. And that's going to be the game. We get a close 21-14 victory over the University of Virginia, guys. And especially against our conference rivals. That was huge. That was amazing. And we can't complain. Look at that. Is definitely play of the game. I could never agree anymore with that play right there. Smith came up huge, stopped that score that was about to happen before the half. And a huge momentum shift here for this crowd and for the team, guys. So you can see we are hyped because you can't let your conference rival beat you at home. And we did not do that. So that's it, though, guys. You guys are getting a couple more highlights. As you see, Tyler Woods, our quarterback, does get player of the game. And you guys are going to see a highlight in the final score here. But that's going to do it for me, though. Guys, I am out of here. It's your boy, Cody, with Babe Gaming. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button if you guys are not already subscribed to me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Add me on Skype at Babe Gaming. Follow me on Twitter at Babe Gaming. Hey, do all this for SGU, too. Let's give a hand for SGU. Thanks, bro, for letting me post again. And I'm out of here, guys. I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.